Hey, welcome everybody. This is part four of my Macaw Parrot oil painting. And I just want to try to finish up the underpainting today and then let it dry, then move on to the overpainting. So I'll move the camera over so you can see what's going on here. Little chilly out here. I have my jacket on. Hopefully it starts to warm up today. Everybody's having a happy Friday today. Friday, what's today? The 22nd, January. Now, need to work on this area here. Underpaint some of the white areas. A little bit of white, a little bit of alkyd medium. Small little brush. Small enough. Touching these really wet areas. That's a little wet there from yesterday. Closer. See it well. Okay. Maybe I'll bring it a little bit closer than I usually do here. See it as good as possible. Yeah, wait. You straight white. Never mind, I'm going to put a touch of burnt umber into it just to kind of lighten it a little. Change the flavor of it just slightly. It's not straight white. Umber. Reshape this area here. Shape the eye. I kind of lost the shape of the eye as I was painting. Should be a round shape around a black pupil. Better. Just trying to go into these little areas here and just kind of put in little dots of white. Little dots of white here and there. Some longer shapes on this side. Longer shapes and the dots, back and forth between longer shapes and the dots. bigger shape over here. Down, down. Lighter paint over here. Change the shape of this line right here, bring that down a little bit more. Take a little black, a little bit of red. Black, a little bit of red, crimson red. Deepen this darker in here. The shape of it, right? That, deepen that in there. Very long to here. Just gonna change some of the shapes. Darker in there. That sort of lighten it as it goes that way. A little bit of grayness into it. Red. It's a little red light over here. Over this way. Or some lighter color. I know this is kind of, I don't want to say boring, but it's a little bit, not the word is. A little bit tedious putting in details. Try not to make these videos boring. Sometimes I do the details off camera sometimes just to, this doesn't get too boring. A lighter color, kind of work some in there. Just a tiny bit right there. Okay. So that part, I'm gonna grab another plate. Million little white, little black, very umber. If you get too much paint on my hands, in a mid-tone, the beak. And I want it too white. Kind of a grayish color. Grayish red color. This is sort of like a glaze. So I'm using a lot of medium and not too much paint. Bring that to the end. Shapes the end of that. Take some medium and paint the edge of that. Yeah. darker color. Go along the side, the edge. Down to there. Put one stroke and blend it in a little. Blend it in more. Some of that color again, kind of some of that dark top. Take some bite. Bottom a little bit here, is it a lighter? There. Get in a little. It's black right here. I'm gonna create too much. And a little bit of gray, kind of bring the two areas together right in there. On the edge, maybe a little bit darker in there. Tiny bit along the edge. Make it look a little bit more round. Better shape to it now too. And whenever you, I blend, I use a dry brush. Wash the brush and dry it. You never want to blend with a wet brush. Blend is always a clean, dry brush. All right, now I'll take some black. Paint the tip of that. The very tip is black. This goes back a little bit grayer here, layer. Area paint right there. A little bit grayer right here. Add in a little, it's not as strong looking.
looking decent there.
It is good. The sauce, well, let me work on some of these. What time is it? 9? A little bit late with my other job, real estate. So let me put some green out and some yellow. Work on some of these feathers here. Need some green, yellow, and white. A little bit of brown to dull it. Take green, white, yellow, and brown. Shape some of these feathers here. Yellow. Let's change the color there a little bit. That got a little bit too dark looking. Others. Up here. Dark one up there. See, this brush isn't working right now, is it? This brush isn't too good. There are flat brushes, and then there are flat brushes that are thinner. They work a little bit better for this. That's what I need to get. This is more of a round flat brush. Some wet paint there, so I just want to kind of go over it loosely there from yesterday. Caution, wet paint. Colors, right? Let's stick it out here. That was the wrong color. Different brush. And just go into where the areas are lighter. Highlight some of them. Like right there and there. Just bit me. You know spring's gonna come when you get bit by bugs. So overlap a little. This dark color. Let's put a, get some sheet tap here and there, a little bit of veins in the middle of them, a little bit of shadows on them. Oops. Fix that there. There, sort of overlap. All right, so I think that's where I'll stop today. I was gonna do all of this down here and kind of work it further, but I think I'll leave it there for now and just kind of take a break and come back tomorrow and finish the underpainting. So hopefully everybody's having a happy Friday today. Have a happy Friday. Please like, share, and subscribe if you like this video, and thanks for watching. See you next time.